1899. No. Let me be precise. These are the dying minutes of 1899. The last slow breath of a century. And here in London, we are watching a new era begin. The British Empire covers a quarter of the globe. Europe is at peace. It is a moment of hope. Tick tock. Our 20th century. Can you hear it drawing near? I am H.G. Wells. I'm a writer, 33 years old, and I wrote The War of the Worlds. Since its publication, just over a year ago, people have begun thinking of me as a prophet. How strange to be thought of as having the gift of foresight. One day, just a few years ago, out walking with my brother Frank, near my home in Surrey, he turned to me. He turned to me and said, suppose some beings from another planet were to suddenly drop out of the sky. Creatures of superior power let loose amongst some gentle savages. And in that instant, I had a story. Let me tell you about fantastic fiction, about scientific romance. It works, because from the first to the last, there is nothing in it that seems impossible. Tick tock. There's a terror in it. My War of the Worlds. A Halloween night terror. The terror of a practical joke. Of screaming in fear when we know deep in our hearts that we are safe and that the ghost is just a man wearing a white sheet. These Martians who are brains without bodies, without love for lesser beings, who teach us that even though we think ourselves powerful, we may not be safe after all. One day, like the Martians, we will launch craft across the ocean of space. One day, too, from space will come the answering call of life. Let us hope it is a voice reaching out in kindness. Tick tock. Suddenly hear not celebration, but the sounds of Martians coming. The sounds of capsules sent across a galaxy. The sound of heat rays warming. Listen. Can you hear them drawing near?
No one would have believed in the last years of the 19th century that human affairs were being watched by intelligences which inhabited the timeless worlds of space. No one could have dreamed we were being scrutinized as someone with a microscope studies creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Few men even considered the possibility of life on other planets. And yet, across the gulf of space, minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded this Earth with envious eyes. And slowly and surely, they drew their plans against us. chance of